Thank you for having me. It is such a pleasure to be here. I'm Lade Araba, co-founder and president of the Visiola Foundation, a nonprofit that educates, trains, and mentors African girls and young women from underserved communities in the science, technology, engineering, and math fields, the STEM fields. Schools were a safe haven for girls. There, they were shielded from potential abuse from family members and other people in their communities. They were shielded from early marriage, and they also did not have to work and run chores to support the family. They were able to focus on their education. Unfortunately, with the global COVID-19 pandemic, many of them are now at home where they don't have reliable electricity access, they don't have computers, they also don't have internet access. So they are basically being cut off from education. So the Visiola Foundation pivoted. We started to run virtual classes and other virtual programs, camps, to enable these students from underserved communities to continue their educational journey. To do this, we have had to provide them with mobile data, internet access packages. We have had to be very creative in how we deliver our learning opportunities. So we are sending messages via text messages. We are utilizing WhatsApp groups where we also share pre-recorded videos that the girls can watch. We utilize a number of social media platforms as well. And effectively, we are having to do a lot more mentoring and coaching so that we follow up with these girls, we monitor and evaluate their progress, and we're able to provide them with, you know, the emotional support that they need to while they're studying. What needs to happen when schools open back up and post COVID-19 is a complete revamping of the educational sector. The curriculum needs to be modernized, updated, facilities need to be improved, teachers need to be upskilled, and most importantly, the pedagogy for delivering instruction needs to evolve. Students need visual aids, they need access to technology, they need to be able to utilize materials that are available to them, even if they can't afford expensive equipment. And very importantly, they need to be provided with real-time feedback to monitor their progress and to make sure they're actually learning. What we know from our experience is that students retain over 60% of information, which then becomes knowledge, when they're able to see it and when they're able to build with their hands. So rote memorization and one-directional instruction where they only hear lectures is not an effective way of really learning and deepening their understanding. Thank you so much for having me.